Aggressive defense gave Washington State fits. And when the Beavers' offense got the ball, Randy Holmes compounded the Cougars' problem. A coach's dream at running back, Holmes ran, blocked, and caught passes all over the field. The Cougars would go on to the Holiday Bowl, but they'd remember the fullback from Boise who ran for over 100 yards against them. The Cougar offense will also remember Jerome Boyd. Give the Beavers an E for effort against the Huskies. Washington would go on to the Rose Bowl at the end of the season, but Oregon State was not impressed. Junior safety Terry Harris highlighted the defensive play, and Randy Holmes just missed getting his second consecutive 100-yard game. There was no let-up in effort on the Beavers' part, not from the younger members of this team. Sophomore fullback Bryce Oglesby showed he'll be an exciting player to watch in the coming years. It was a prelude of coming seasons this day at Norman, Oklahoma. The powerful Sooners were not awesome in the eyes of the fledglings on the Beavers squad. The youngsters made things happen. Quarterbacks Jay Kirschenman and James Burton generated enthusiasm. And when they gave the ball to players like Bryce Oglesby and James Terrell and freshman Darvin Malone, you could feel the excitement of the future. Safety Terry Harris rallied the defensive secondary as OSU played the California Bears in Berkeley. James Burton, starting at quarterback, showed his ability to keep defenders guessing on the option, while Randy Holmes again provided a threat as both a runner and a receiver. Mike Cagle generated excitement as a receiver, as did James Terrell. Spelling Burton at quarterback, Jay Kirschenman advanced the ball in the air and on the ground. Again, it was the defensive play of Terry Harris and Jerome Boyd that had the Beavers fans excited as the Stanford Cardinals invaded Parker Stadium. Junior split end Tim Sim renewed his acquaintance with the football, too. Freshman Kenny Taylor defended well against the awesome passing attack of John Elway. And freshman Kenny Lawson got the fans on their feet with several exciting runs. Midway into the fourth quarter, Bryce Oglesby got his first collegiate touchdown off this series of plays engineered by Jay Kirschenman. And it's all in the drop of the cards.
Lightning strikes. Breath of life.
The Beavers youngsters really got into the act against Arizona. Angelo DeLulo and Reggie DuPay kept the Wildcats offense guessing, while Terry Harris again turned in a sterling performance at the safety spot. He finished the game with 8 tackles, 3 assists, and 2 interceptions. This Harris theft sets up a Tim Sim reverse for the first score of the game. And the excitement continued as OSU pulls off another patented onside kick.
Onside kick by Mandel. They're going for everything and they're going to get the ball. Beaver football to the 50-yard line.
Kenny Lawson can not only run, but showed he has the hands of a receiver as well in this diving catch late in the game. You could have called the 85th meeting between the Ducks and the Beavers the James Terrell Show, as the 190-pound, 6'1" freshman tailback spent the first half of the game grinding out yards on the ground or sprinting out on pass patterns. Fourth quarter action also saw freshman Tyrone Henderson on the receiving end of a pair of Ed Singler passes. And once again, old number 31, Randy Holmes, turned in yet another workmanlike performance. In Randy's first 2 seasons, he's rushed for over 1,000 yards and caught 27 passes for over 250. Ed Singler ended the 1981 season with 1,500 yards passing and now ranks 4th in OSU career passing. Junior Chris Mangold finished the year 26 for 26 in extra points.
One very interesting aspect about the 1981 season was that sports writers and fans were able to say, well, coach, what happened to your team later in the season as opposed to the beginning of the season? Well, I think it's a very good question. Certainly some things caught up to us. But in 1980, nobody asked questions like that because we weren't close to people. Now, in 1981, they saw us score a number of points against Southern Cal. They saw us play nothing to nothing halftime tie with a very good Washington State football team. They saw us play very competitively with the University of Washington for the first half. They saw us win. They saw us come very close. All these things make people excited. I think our 1982 football team, with the maturity of the people that we have on our team, and the addition of a very good recruiting class, will make us even more competitive. No one said that this was going to be an overnight job, never intended for it to be. How it will get done is with a continued recruiting effort, putting back-to-back freshman classes like the one we have on campus right now, mold that into the total organization. When this is done, then we will have a competitive program. So what we're looking for is, again, in the future, to make improvement. And how you make improvement is to be organized, to be disciplined, and to improve your talent level.